Oh, we have a clap! Oh, that's so cool!
G'day everyone, as you can see, I'm in the Windows 10 video editor. Educators like you have been asking for a full-featured set of video creation and editing tools that inspire students to tell stories and express themselves in this digital world, and guess what? It's already on your Windows 10 device. Let me show you how easy it is. Now, I would normally start with an intro like, "This is what's new in EDU, where we bring you all the latest innovation and announcements in education technology." Add an effect if you like. Next, let's add a title card. Now, we recently asked you on social what you'd like to see more of in these episodes and what would help you the most. Victoria commented that she'd like to see
more information on creating an inclusive math classroom, please.
This is so important as STEM continues to be such a priority. Great comment, Victoria. Since you're a math teacher, we have Math Assistant in OneNote Online. Students can create practice math quizzes to work on problems just like the one they've created. And in this math pane, you can launch the immersive reader for step-by-step math solutions. We've also launched an interactive guide for inclusive math. Victoria also mentioned that she had
tons of resources if you'd like to collaborate.
So of course we did. We visited her to hear how she creates an inclusive classroom.
Thanks, Mark. I'm excited to share my tips and tricks with you all. Here are my top four. Tip number one, student-created forms through Microsoft Forms. You can actually make feedback trackers through forms, both before and after assessments, quizzes, tests, whatever you want. You ask students how they did, how they wanted to do, and what they can do to improve or either keep their grade. This is great in subjects like math because Forms has math notation, which is something I'm really not seeing from any other platform right now. Tip number two is your voice your choice and honesty hour. These are great ways in Teams, classroom websites, or forms to see how the kids are doing in your classroom. For example, for honesty hour with my students, through a Microsoft form, I'll ask them in math class, "Did you study? Be honest." And from there, we can export those results to an Excel, and I can compile the information to see if their classroom expectations match up with their actual performance in my room. For tip number three, we're going to do digital breakouts. So if you've done a physical breakout, it usually comes with a lockbox and several locks and clues. To speed up the process, you can use Microsoft Forms, and you can actually drop clues in sections for students to solve. Once they're done with that particular section, it takes them to the next one. And with Immersive Reader, you can actually have students integrate that if they maybe struggle with a language, or maybe if they're English language learners. Tip number four is correct or incorrect, which you can also do through Forms or Word. With digital inking, notation, and also just different capabilities, you can drop in questions and images and have students spot, circle, or annotate what is right or not right about each problem. Thanks for tuning in for my tips and tricks. You can follow me on Twitter at VictoriaTheTech. I'd love to connect with you all. Back to you, Mark.
Thanks, Victoria. Let's change the music. Okay, great. Now, we have a variety of learning tools that are free and available in the products that you use in the classroom every day. If you're wondering how to get started, this one-stop immersive reader page on the Microsoft Educator Center is a great training guide. It shows all of the apps and platforms as well as many helpful links. I know Victoria mentioned this, but you have to check out Immersive Reader in Forms. Big deal, especially for the inclusive classroom. Now, let's talk hacking STEM, but let's make a transition. Without opening up a web browser, let's search for a transition slide, add a title card, and now we're off. Starting this November, the world will celebrate the 20-year anniversary of humans living aboard the International Space Station. We've partnered with NASA to develop 8 new lesson plans, including the things astronauts need to consider when living in space. And these lessons are free. Here's how Ashley is using the Hacking STEM lesson in her classroom in Fishers, Indiana.
Thanks. Hi, I'm Ashley and I teach biomedical innovations here in Fishers, Indiana. Our class is all based about solving health-related problems, and so the AstroSoc activity was a perfect fit because it allowed us to concentrate on the health of an astronaut while working through the design process. We have some examples to share with you. So our first example here of our AstroSoc. Hey guys, what did you learn during this activity?
One of the things we learned was how to use our past designs to inspire new modifications.
Perfect. I have another example down here. Ladies, what did you learn during this activity?
One of the things we learned was to think outside the box using limited resources.
Good. We enjoyed hacking STEM, and we hope you will try it too. Thanks. Back to you.
Thanks, Ashley. Teaching STEM empowers learners to develop critical skills. Now, a lot of you mentioned also wanting to learn more about coding, so we've compiled a few great resources. Computer Science Education Week is coming. Get ready. The second week in December. Start planning fun hour of code activities with any of the Make Code editors. And if you've never gone to makecode.com before, check it out. We have free and fun projects for learners at different levels. Now let's get into events. Eric from Columbus, Georgia, take it away.
Hey everybody, it is Mr. Crouch. I'm a fifth grade teacher in
Columbus, Georgia.
And my students and I are so excited to be joining everyone this year for Microsoft's Global Learning Connection event, formerly known as Skype-a-thon, November 5th and 6th. It's gonna be amazing because we love Skype. We love Mystery Skype. We love everything. We love bringing in experts, and we cannot wait to join all of you. That's November 5th and 6th. We'll see all of you there. Bye everybody, we'll see you soon.
Thanks, Eric. How inspiring and fun. We're excited to be on this journey together with all of you to learn from you. If you have any recommendation or ideas on what you'd like to see next month, reach out. And for all the info and resources I mentioned, check out the links below or in the blog, and make sure to try our video editor for yourself. You can add really cool effects, maybe some autumn leaves falling because it's that time of the year over here, or a confetti fountain coming out of my hands. Thank you, and see you next time.
Yeah. Did I do it right? Okay.